Welcome back to another exciting episode of the Bright in the Corner Children's Broadcast. My name is Brother Jared, and as always, it is great to have you with us. If you and your family are enjoying these broadcasts, please help us to share these videos with others so that they too can receive a blessing.
Hey kids, this is Miss Hannah, tuning in to say hello and welcome you to today's program. This week we'll be learning about our awesome God and the amazing Creation Week. So sit back and get ready to enjoy this special time of singing and teaching from the Word of God.
Who made the world's foundation? Who laid Earth's cornerstone? Who gave the sea its boundary and made the oceans foam? Who calls the sun each morning, come travel through the sky? There's only one who has the power. It is God, and God alone. Great are you, Lord, great is your majesty. Reigning over all the earth, exalted high. Great are you, Lord, great is your holiness. Ruling over all the earth and sky. Your greatness fills the day with light, and thunders in the night, declaring all the glory of your might. Great are you, Lord, great is your majesty. Great are you, Lord. Who saw that man was sinful? Who saw that man was lost? Who left his throne in paradise to die upon a cross? Who left the grave victorious and rolled away the stone? There's only one who has the power. It is God, and God alone. Great are you, Lord, great is your majesty. Reigning over all the earth, exalted high. Great are you, fills the day with light and thunders in the night, declaring all the glory of your might. Great are you, Lord, great is your majesty. Great are you, Lord, great are you, Lord, great are you, Lord, great.
This week's memory verse is Psalm 139:14a, and it says, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Let's say that again together. Psalm 139:14a, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Now's the time to pause the program and go back and memorize the memory verse for today. And don't forget just how special you are. You are created by God Himself, and He loves you very much.
Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Today we are going to learn about how our great God created the universe and the world around us in only 6 days. The Genesis account of the Creation Week is not a make-believe story or a fairy tale. God's word is true. And in Genesis chapter 1, we learn how God spoke with his mighty voice and created our beautiful world from absolutely nothing. This is the most amazing and exciting event ever recorded in human history. So be sure to listen closely as we learn about our awesome God and the creation week. Day 1, the first day of creation. On the first day of creation, God created the heaven and the earth out of nothing. Have you ever made a craft at school or built something just for fun at home? Maybe you formed a house or a flower or a car out of Play-Doh. You came up with the idea, which made you the designer, but you still had to use the Play-Doh to make your design. Growing up, we used to play with Legos. We had a large chest full of all kinds of Lego bricks, and we would build entire cities out of them. Although we were the designers of the cities and the builders of the cities, we still had to use the bricks to build them. We were not creators in the way that God created the earth. The amazing thing about God when he created the world was that he created it out of nothing. He didn't have any kind of material or supplies. God simply spoke with his mighty voice, and the heavens and the earth appeared. Because only God can do this, only God deserves our worship and our praise. He is our creator, and we are a part of his creation. In Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 through 5, God tells us that on day 1, God created the heavens and the earth, but everything was still covered in darkness. Right now where you're at, close your eyes and try to imagine a world in complete darkness. Perhaps you've been in a cave or a dark room that was so dark you couldn't even see your hand in front of your face. It would be very difficult to move about, let alone to live in a world without any light. So, in verse number 3, God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God then called the light day, and the darkness he called night. This completed the very first day of creation. Now, day number 2. On the second day of creation, God separated the waters that covered the earth from the waters that are in the clouds and in the skies by creating what is called the firmament. The firmament is what we call the atmosphere today. It's where the birds, the airplanes, and even your kite flies. God created the firmament to separate the waters of the earth from the waters in the skies. This began what scientists call today the hydrologic cycle, or the water cycle. What an amazing God we serve. Even from the very beginning of time, he knew that the earth would need to be watered in order for plants to grow. So he designed clouds in the skies to be his very own watering pitchers to water the entire earth. On day number 3, the third day of creation, God caused the dry land to appear. He divided the waters from the dry land and called the land earth, and the waters seas. He did this in verse number 10. Then, in verse number 11, God said, "Let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after his kind." God once again showed us how much he loves us by creating a beautiful world for us to live in. On day 3, God made the mountains and the rivers, the flowers and the trees, the delicious fruits, the nuts and the vegetables that we enjoy. God made all of the beautiful plants with their brilliant colors and all of the different kinds of trees with their decorative leaves. God made the branches, God made the stems, God made the trunks that the trees grow on. Just think about how many different types of plants there are in this world. God designed and created all of them in one day with his mighty voice. What a great God we have. But God was not finished creating yet. On day number 4, the fourth day of creation, God created the sun. He called it the greater light to rule the day, and the moon, the lesser light to rule the night. God also created the trillions of stars that are scattered across our vast universe. Many of those stars are even bigger than the sun. And scientists today cannot count all of them, for there are simply too many to count. But God knows exactly how many stars there are in the heavens. Psalm 147:4 tells us that God even knows their names. What an amazing and wise God you and I serve. Day number 5. On the fifth day of creation, God said, "Let the waters bring forth abundantly the moving creature that hath life, and the fowl that may fly above the earth in the open firmament of heaven." And God created great whales and every living creature that moveth, which the waters brought forth abundantly, after their kind, and every winged fowl after his kind. And God saw that it was good. That is verses 20 through 21. God created all the fish in the seas, from the tiny minnow to the giant whale. God made the goldfish, the sharks, the starfish, the sea turtles, the jellyfish, and so much more. God also made all the birds of the skies that day. He made the sparrows, the eagles, the crows, the peacocks, the doves, the parrots, and many other types of birds. But God still had more to create. On day number 6, God created all the land animals. In verse 24, God said, "Let the earth bring forth the living creature after his kind, cattle and creeping thing and beast of the earth after his kind," and it was so. On the 6th day, God made the giraffes, the zebras, the elephants, the horses, the buffalo, the grizzly bears, the squirrels, the dogs, the cats, the deer, the cows, the chickens, and even the skunks. God made all the animals in one day. But God still was not finished creating. For on that day, he would create his most amazing creation. In verse 26, the Bible says, "God said, 'Let us make man in our image after our likeness.'" And in verse 27, God's word goes on to say, "So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them." Of all of the amazing things that God created, mankind was his crowning creation. For only mankind was made in the image of God. You see, you and I are special to God. We were created differently from the animals, from the fish, and from the birds. We are the only creatures who possess an eternal soul, one that will live forever like God. The Word of God tells us that God formed Adam, the first man, out of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Verse number 7 of chapter 2. Because human beings were created in the image of God and have the breath of God in them, human life is special and sacred in God's eyes. We have heard a lot of talk recently about different lives that matter, but the truth is, in God's eyes, all lives matter. All lives are special to God. So whether your skin is black, white, or brown, or whether you are a baby, a child, a teenager, an adult, or even a senior citizen, all lives matter to God, because God is the creator of all life. That is why false teachings such as evolution are wrong and even dangerous. They teach us that we evolved from an animal such as a monkey or a tadpole, and evolution would have us believe that we are simply a more intelligent animal. That is why people who believe this false teaching do not respect life. They don't recognize that God is the creator of life, and that as human beings, we are made in his image. Evil men such as Adolf Hitler and Joseph Stalin throughout history believed in evolution, and they thought that people were simply animals. Because of this, they had millions of innocent people put to death. How sad and how tragic. But many of those who believe in evolution and other wrong teachings begin to think that they are better than other people because of their skin color, the language they speak, or even the country they came from. God's word, however, teaches us the complete opposite. Because God is the creator of all life, and because all people are made in his image, therefore all people are equally special to God. In fact, God loved the whole world and all the people in the world so much that in John chapter 3, verse 16, we are told, "God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." If you have never placed your trust in God's Son, Jesus Christ, you should do so today. But we're not finished yet. Day number 7. Well, let's review as we get to the 7th day. In 6 literal days, God created the universe and the entire world that we live in. At the end of the 6th day, God looked upon all that he had created, and he said that it was very good. Then, on the 7th day, God rested and blessed the 7th day and sanctified it. That is why each week we set aside a special day of rest to honor God. Initially, that day was Saturday, but now we celebrate that day on Sunday because Jesus Christ rose from the grave on the first day of the week. When God finished creating the world, it was perfect. There was no sin in the world, and even the animals got along together. The lion and the lamb could lay down together in the same field without any fear of danger or of death. Only later, when mankind disobeyed God, would sin enter into the world and bring with it sorrow, pain, and suffering. But Jesus Christ willingly came to this earth and lived a sinless life. He was crucified on an old rugged cross and died in our place to pay for our sins and also for the sins of the world. Because of His sacrifice, you and I can choose to place our trust in Him. And one day, we too can experience a perfect world at His return and live forever in a perfect place called heaven. Romans 10:13 says, "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." Here is a short poem that can help us to remember the creation week that we have just learned. It goes like this. Day one brought heaven, earth, and light. God's glory shone so very bright. Day two, God made the clear blue sky, a place where one day birds would fly. Day three brought land apart from seas with all the plants and grass and trees. Day four shone forth moon, stars, and sun, but God's creation was not done. Day five, He made the fish and birds. God did all this with just His words. Day six, God formed all beasts and man to finish His creation plan. Day seven was especially blessed, a day of worship and of rest. Thank you so much for listening today as we have learned about our amazing God and the incredible creation week. We will now go to our final song for the Bright in the Corner Children's Broadcast.
Whoa, that was such an awesome lesson, Brother Jared. Isn't it wonderful to know that you were created by an amazing God, boys and girls? He loves you very much and has such a special plan for your life if you will just give your heart to Him and allow Him to have control. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel, and be sure to tell your friends. See you next time!